For weeks, Ko Wen-je has led the opinion polls, often with a double-digit lead over his rival from the Kuomintang party. When the time came to cast his vote, Mr. Ko seemed pensive. But the mandate he's won from the people of Taipei is clear. Mr. Ko campaigned as an independent, but his political views are close to those of the opposition DPP. Saturday's vote has seen its candidates swept into office across Taiwan.
I think it's an unprecedented election. It's an overwhelming victory for the DPP. And I think it shows that the KMT has not been performing well. And the divisions within the KMT have meant that people within Taiwan don't trust it anymore.
Ko Wen-je's defeated rival is this man, Sean Lien. As KMT party candidate, he favoured closer ties with Beijing based on the acceptance of the One China Doctrine, something many young Taiwanese reject. This year, thousands of students staged a sit-in protest in Parliament that lasted 28 days. They were angry at the prospect of a new trade deal with the mainland. That is something DPP supporters say their party will not do.
To normalize trade relations between Taiwan and China is very important. However, putting all our investment in China or only concentrate in our trade relations with China may not be healthy for Taiwan. It's like putting all eggs in one basket.
Although Saturday's vote in Taiwan was for local government, analysts say it will have a much wider effect.
People of Hong Kong have been paying very, very close attention to the elections here in Taiwan this time around, given what's going on in Hong Kong with the umbrella movement. But other countries in all around the region, in Southeast Asia as well, have been paying keen interest.
For President Ma Ying-jeou, this election has been disastrous. His KMT party's pro-China policy now appears to be a vote loser. The premier of his government has resigned, and he is now facing a much stronger opposition 2 years out from the general election. Dominic Kane, Al Jazeera.